An instrument approach is a critical phase of flight that allows an aircraft to approach and land safely, especially in conditions of reduced visibility. It involves precise navigation using flight instruments and navigation systems to guide the aircraft to the runway. It's crucial for pilots to be well versed in these procedures for safety and efficiency in flight operations. In this video, we'll break down the most important points a pilot must understand about instrument approaches. Before we begin, click the like and subscribe button to catch more of Epic Flight Academy's aviation content. Let's get started. There are numerous types of approaches for landings. Student pilots begin with visual approaches by using ground references. Pilots must be able to operate aircraft with visual reference to the ground and visually avoid obstructions and other aircraft. Also, keeping a clear head is instrumental to safety. Nearly half of all commercial jet accidents occur on final, so this is a crucial part of flight training. Student pilots also learn how to read approach charts and plates to receive clearance. Pilots take safety measures during every phase of approach. During the landing process, passengers feel the plane reduce altitude or step down. The plane then powers ahead, followed by another step down. This is a common landing procedure. Aircraft flight manuals recommend correct speeds. Of course, these vary between heavy jumbo jets and light aircraft. If the weather is less than visual flight rules prescribe, pilots must use instrument flight rules. Pilots operate aircraft by referencing the instruments rather than visual reference by looking outside the aircraft. As a result, IFR operations require specific training and certification of the pilot. Also, the aircraft is required to have increased equipment requirements and certification. Above all, pilots must file an IFR flight plan. Instrument approaches allow an instrument-rated pilot to transition from the flight to the approach in instrument meteorological conditions, and then to the landing. EPIC students learn about and fly all three categories of instrument approaches in a simulator and the aircraft. The three types of instrument approaches are precision approaches, non-precision approaches, and approaches with vertical guidance. A precision approach is an approach in which pilots receive vertical and lateral guidance through ground-based navigation aids or satellite-generated navigation data displayed in the cockpit. Furthermore, air traffic control can also provide the pilot radar vectors to the runway. There are three types. The instrument landing system is the most commonly available precision approach in the United States. It uses both a localizer and a glide slope ground-based signal that are transmitted to the aircraft receiver, guiding pilots to the runway. FAR 91.175 explains the requirements for landing, such as flight visibility and approved visual references. Ground-based augmentation system approaches provide exact alignment and descent guidance to aircraft. To the pilot, these approaches look similar to ILS approaches. The local area augmentation system is based on GPS signals that are then supplemented by ground equipment. Precision approach radar approaches involve radar and two-way radio communications. The controller provides the pilot headings, altitudes, and necessary corrections to remain on course. The military mostly uses precision approach radar approaches in the United States. Non-precision approaches are standard instrument approach procedures with only lateral guidance from the localizer signal. Vertical guidance is not provided. There are eight types. Area navigation approaches use the Global Navigation Satellite System, or GPS. RNAV approaches are becoming more common due to the wide use of GPS. An aircraft must be equipped with the appropriate Wide Area Augmentation System GPS receiver to conduct the RNAV approach. RNAV approaches vary on capabilities. Some RNAV approaches will also have LPV, localizer performance with vertical guidance, known as APV approaches. Localizer performance approaches are non-precision approaches with WAS lateral guidance. Vertical guidance to the runway is not provided. Furthermore, the localizer performance approaches are located where terrain or obstructions do not allow a vertically guided procedure. In order to conduct a localizer performance approach, the aircraft must be equipped with the appropriate Wide Area Augmentation System GPS receiver. Very high-frequency omnidirectional range approaches use a ground-based signal transmitting an omnidirectional radial. VOR signals are line of sight due to terrain blocking. Also, the VOR radials have a range limit, depending on the type of VOR ground device. The US has been decommissioning many VORs. However, pilots must retain skills on flying a VOR approach, because many countries still use VOR. Non-directional beacon approach is a ground-based, low-frequency radio transmitter. The NDB transmits an omnidirectional signal received by an automatic direction finder instrument aboard the aircraft. NDBs are being phased out of air navigation in the United States, with few remaining. Although there are fewer NDB approaches worldwide than VORs, pilots should maintain their NDB approach skills. Localizer approaches utilize the only localizer equipment of the instrument landing system, and not vertical guidance to the runway. Aircraft must be equipped with a navigation receiver. ILS and localizer signals share the same ground-based equipment. Approach surveillance radar approaches are similar to the PAR, however, they don't provide vertical guidance. As a result, when conducting an ASR approach, air traffic control guides the pilot laterally, giving heading assignments or corrections. Localizer type directional approach is used where the approach is offset from the runway by 6 to 12 degrees. The LDA uses the ground-based transmitter from an ILS, but not a complete ILS signal. In order to fly the LDA approach, the aircraft must be equipped with a navigation receiver. Simplified directional facility approaches are similar to the ILS localizer. Aircraft must be equipped with a navigation receiver to fly this approach. Above all, the course may not be aligned with the runway and may be wider. As a result, there may be less precision. Approaches with vertical guidance is based on a navigation system that does not meet the ICAO precision approach standards. APV approaches provide course and glide path deviation information. Aircraft must have a WAS receiver to fly these approaches. The APV approaches are more accurate than RNAV approaches. Therefore, pilots are able to fly lower cloud and visibility minimums. The APV types of approaches include localizer performance with vertical guidance and LNAV or VNAV. The process of learning the skills for flying instrument approaches and maintaining those skills is highly rewarding. As a result, you'll be able to fly confidently anywhere in the world. We hope this video taught you something new about aviation and how instrument approaches work. Remember, for more videos covering aviation and flight training guidance, subscribe to Epic Flight Academy.